Hi students, today we have to discuss on the particular values, the particular values of trigonometric ratios, So here we have first triangle ABC, that is right angle triangle ABC. In this triangle, angle A is 60 degree. Angle C is 30 degree and angle B is right angle, that is 90 degree. And we know the theorem related with these three angles, or we have a theorem of 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree triangles theorem. We studied this theorem into the 9th standard. See this theorem, name of the theorem is theorem of the triangle 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree. And what we learned in that theorem? Side opposite to angle 30 degree is half of the hypotenuse, and side opposite to angle 60 degree is square root of 3/2 times the hypotenuse. Now suppose here we consider that AC is equal to 2A. Suppose we consider that, let the value of AC, that is 2A. Then what should be the value of AB? As we know that according to theorem of 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree triangle, side opposite to angle 30 degree, see this is angle 30 degree, side opposite to angle 30 degree is AB. And what should be the value of AB? Side opposite to angle 30 degree is half of the hypotenuse. Since the hypotenuse is 2A, we only take the value of AC as 2A. We didn't take it as 5A, 7A, 9A. We only take the value of AC as 2A because half of 2A is A. So the value of side AB is A. And now we have to get the value of BC. As we know that side opposite to angle 60 degree. Side opposite to angle 60 degree, that is, see this side opposite to angle 60 degree BC, it is square root of 3/2 times the hypotenuse. BC is equal to square root of 3/2 into hypotenuse, that is AC. And if we put the values here, BC is equal to square root of 3/2 into 2A, and 2 gets cancelled. So we have BC is equal to square root of 3 into A. So we will write here square root of 3 into A. A is outside this square root, that we have to think carefully. See, so here we get, if we consider the value of AC 2A, janivpurvak apan AC chi value 2A ghetleli ahe, जेणेकरून अदर व्हॅल्यूज आपल्याला इझिली फाईंड करता येतील. आता 2A घ्यावा असं काही नाही, यू कॅन टेक इट ॲज 2K, 2M, 2N, कुठलंही व्हेरिएबल आपण तिथे यूज करू शकतो. वी टेक द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ AC ॲज 2A, सो वी गेट AB इज इक्वल टू A. वाय? बिकॉज साईड अपोजिट टू अँगल 30 डिग्री इज हाफ ऑफ द हायपोटेन्यूज, हायपोटेन्यूज इज 2A, सिन्स AB इज A. And BC is square root of 3 into A. Now here we have to get all the values of this 30 degree angle and this 60 degree angle. So here we can write sine 30. Now what is the definition of sine? The definition of sine is opposite side upon hypotenuse. Opposite side is AB, that is A, upon hypotenuse is 2A. So here AA gets cancelled and we have sine 30 is equal to 1/2. We have sine 30 is equal to 1/2. Now here we have to get cos 30. Cos 30 is equal to, what is the definition of cos ratio for this 30 degree angle? We have to write the cos ratio for the 30 degree angle. Definition of the cos is adjacent side upon hypotenuse, adjacent side of angle 30 degree. That is root 3 into A. divided by hypotenuse is 2a, here a gets cancelled and we have cos 30 is equal to square root of 3 upon 2. Cos 30 is equal to square root of 3 upon 2. Then tan 30, we will get the value of tan 30. We know the definition of tan ratio, opposite side upon adjacent side. Opposite side is a upon adjacent side is root 3 into a. Here a gets cancelled and we have 1 upon root 3, that is tan 30. Now sin, cos, tan, we have to get cot 30. Cot 30 is equal to, what is the definition of cot? That is adjacent side upon opposite side. Adjacent side is root 3 into a upon opposite side is a. Here a gets cancelled and we have root 3 only there. Value of cot 30 is root 3. Now we have to get sec 30. Sec 30 degree is equal to, what is the definition of sec ratio? Hypotenuse upon adjacent side. Hypotenuse is 2a upon adjacent side is adjacent side of angle 30 degree, that is root 3 into a. So here a gets cancelled, we have 2 upon root 3, that is the value of sec 30. And now we have to get the value of cosec 30. What is the definition of cosec ratio? It is hypotenuse upon opposite side. Hypotenuse is 2a upon opposite side is a, and here a gets cancelled and we have cosec 30 is equal to 2. So these are the particular values of the trigonometric ratios for the particular angles. These are the values of trigonometric ratios in terms of particular angle 30 degree. These are all the values of 30 degree angle. For this particular angle 30 degree, we have sin 30 half, cos 30 root 3 upon 2, tan 30 1 upon root 3, cot 30 root 3, sec 30 2 upon root 3, and cosec 30 2. Now similarly, we have to get all the values of the trigonometric ratios for this particular angle 60 degree. We have to get all the trigonometric ratios for this particular angle 60 degree, and we can easily write these value here. Sin 60, what is the definition of sin? For see, this angle is very important. Definition of sin, all of you know that, that is opposite side upon hypotenuse. But opposite side of angle 60 degree, that is root 3 into a upon hypotenuse, it is 2a. Here a gets cancelled and we have root 3 upon 2, that is the value of sin 60. Now we will get cos 60, cos 60 degree. Now the definition of the cos ratio is adjacent side upon hypotenuse, that is a upon 2a. a gets cancelled and we have 1 upon 2. Now we have to get the value of tan 60. The definition is opposite side upon adjacent side of angle 60 degree. Opposite side root 3 into a upon adjacent side a. Sorry, this is a gets cancelled and we have tan 60 is equal to root 3. Now we have to get cot 60. Cot 60 degree is equal to, definition of the cot ratio is adjacent side upon opposite side of angle 60 degree. Adjacent side is a and opposite side is root 3 into a. So a gets cancelled and we have 1 upon root 3. Now we have to get sec 60 degree. Value of trigonometric ratio sec for the angle 60 degree, and it is, see how to write sec ratio, up hypotenuse upon adjacent side. Hypotenuse upon adjacent side, hypotenuse is 2a and adjacent side is a. Is 2a upon a, it is equal to 2 only. And last value, that is cosec 60. The definition of the cosec ratio is hypotenuse upon opposite side. Hypotenuse is 2a and opposite side of angle 60 degree is root 3 into a. Here a gets cancelled and we have 2 upon root 3. So these are the trigonometric values for the particular angles. Trigonometric values of the particular angles for only these two angles, 30 degree and 60 degree. Now we have to get the values for 45 degree. We have to get all the trigonometric values of the angle 45 degree. So here we will use the another theorem, the theorem of 45 degree, 45 degree, 90 degree triangle. Theorem of 45 degree, 45 degree, 90 degree triangle theorem. What that theorem says? It says that if the angles of the triangle are 45 degree, 45 degree, 90 degree, at that time side opposite to angle 45 degree is 1 upon square root of 2 times the hypotenuse. 1 upon square root of 2 times the hypotenuse, that is the measurement of the side opposite to angle 45 degree. See, this is right angle triangle PQR having both the angles 45 degree, 45 degree, means it is isosceles right angle triangle. And now suppose here we take the hypotenuse. Suppose here we take the hypotenuse as, suppose we will consider the sides first. This is a, this is a, so it will become square root of 2 into a by using Pythagoras theorem. If this side measures a and this side measures a, both the sides are equal, that is isosceles right angle. So we have to take the same variables for these two sides and we have to get the value of PR by using Pythagoras theorem, that is square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the square of the remaining two sides. Suppose we have to get this value PR. So you have PR square is equal to PQ square plus QR square, that is A square plus A square, that is 2A square, and square root of 2A square is root 2 into A. Now here you can find all the trigonometric ratios in terms of this particular angle 45 degree. So we will write sin 45 first. What is the definition of sin ratio? How to write sin? Now maybe some students here gets fumbled because we have two angles having the same measurements, that is 45 degree. You can write the sin ratio for one of the two angles, for any one angle, either for this angle P or for this angle R, you will get the same value. So here sin 45, opposite side upon hypotenuse, opposite side is A, hypotenuse is 2A, AA gets cancelled and sin 45 is equal to 1 upon square root of 2. Then we have to write cos 45. The definition of the cos ratio is adjacent side for this angle, adjacent side is A upon hypotenuse is root 2 into A, AA gets cancelled and we have the value of cos 45, that is 1 upon root 2. Then tan 45, the definition is opposite side upon adjacent side, that is A upon A, it is equal to 1. Then we have to write cot 45. Definition of the cot ratio is adjacent side upon opposite side, that is again A upon A, that is equal to 1. Then we have to write the value of sec 45, that is hypotenuse upon adjacent side, hypotenuse is root 2 into A upon opposite side is A, since A gets cancelled, we have sec 45 is equal to root 2, and now we have to get cosec 45. And the definition is hypotenuse, that is root 2 upon A, root 2 into A upon opposite side, that is A. Here A gets cancelled and we have root 2. Sin 45 is 1 upon root 2, cos 45 is 1 upon root 2, tan 45 is 1, cot 45 is 1, sec 45 is equal to root 2 and cosec 45 is equal to root 2. So these are the values of trigonometric ratios for the particular angle 45 degree. Now we have to get these trigonometric values for the angle 0 degree. For the angle 0 degree. Now suppose See this, we have right angle triangle XYZ here, and now we have to get the trigonometric values in terms of 0 degree angle. For the particular angle 0 degree, we have to get the trigonometric values. Here, see this angle, we didn't know the measurement of this angle, this theta. But suppose we have to make it 0. Since we have to get the particular values of trigonometric ratios for the angle 0 degree, so here we have to make this angle 0. And suppose you have to make this angle 0, then we have to submerge this side xz into the yz. See, we have to take the distance, we have to get less distance. Here suppose this is 30 degree angle, let it be 30 degree, we have to make it 0. We consider that it is 30 degree angle, that angle measures 30 degree, and we have to make it 0. So what we have to do, we have to submerge this side xz. See, downside, we will take this side here, then we will take this side here, then we will take this side here, and the angle is going to become less, and at a certain time it will become 0. And when this angle becomes 0, at that time xz is equal to yz. This side xz is converted into the side yz. आपण असं कन्सिडर केलं की हा अँगल, ॲक्च्युली आपल्याला याचं मेजरमेंट माहिती नाही आहे, परंतु आपण असं कन्सिडर केलं की हा 30 डिग्री आहे आणि आपल्याला त्याला 0 डिग्रीमध्ये कन्वर्ट करायचं आहे. मग त्याला जर 0 डिग्रीमध्ये कन्वर्ट करायचं असेल तर हा जो साईड साधारण एक्स झेड नावाची साईड आहे, ती साईड आपल्याला काय करावी लागेल, एक्स झेड आणि वाय झेड या दोघांमधलं डिस्टन्स कमी 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 करत यावं लागेल. आणि ज्यावेळेस हे डिस्टन्स इथल्या ह्या दोघांमधला जो गॅप आहे तो 0 डिग्री झालेला असेल, त्यावेळेस एक्स झेड आणि वाय झेड दोघं इक्वल झालेले असतील. सो व्हेन दिस अँगल झेड बिकम्स 0 डिग्री, ॲट दॅट टाईम वी हॅव एक्स झेड इज इक्वल टू वाय झेड. When angle z becomes 0 degree, at that time we have xz is equal to yz. We have xz is equal to yz and xy is equal to 0. And xy is equal to 0. See, this distance is going to become less, less, less and less. And when this angle becomes 0, at that time this distance xy, side xy becomes 0, and these xz and yz are going to be equal. So here we have xz is equal to yz and xy is equal to 0. Now we have to get all the values of angle 0 degree. So here we have to write sin 0. How to write sin 0? Definition of sin is opposite side upon hypotenuse. Opposite side upon hypotenuse. See, this opposite side is 0 upon hypotenuse is xz, and 0 divided by xz is 0 only. So we have sin 0 is equal to 0. Then we have to write cos 0. How to write cos 0? Definition of the cos ratio is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. For this angle 0, adjacent side is yz upon hypotenuse is xz, and we know that yz is equal to xz. So the division of the two, xz divided by yz upon xz is 1. Same number is divided by the same number, that is yz and xz are equal since their division is 1. So we have cos 0 is equal to 1. Now tan 0, opposite side upon opposite side, that is 0 upon adjacent side yz, and it is equal to 0. Tan 0 is 0. Then we have to write cot 0. Cot 0 is equal to adjacent side yz upon opposite side 0, and see, this is not defined. It is not possible to have a zero denominator. In mathematics, it is meaningless If 0 is there in the denominator, then it is meaningless. So we write quad 0 is equal to not defined or not determined. We cannot determine the value of quad 0. Quad 0 ची value आपण सांगू शकत नाही. इथे denominator ला 0 आलेला आहे आणि हे गणितामध्ये निश्चित मानले जाते. कुठल्याही संख्येचा denominator हा 0 असू शकत नाही आणि असेल तर त्याची value अनिश्चित असते, not determined. So we write quad 0 is equal to nd, that is not determined. And then we have sec 0. We have to get the value of sec 0. What is the definition of sec ratio? Hypotenuse upon adjacent side. Hypotenuse is xz. Hypotenuse is xz upon adjacent side is yz, and both are equal, so their division is 1. And now we have to get the value of cosec 0. What is the definition of cosec? Hypotenuse upon opposite side, that is xz upon 0, and it is again not determined. Since the denominator is 0, the value of cosec 0 is not determined. So these are the values, particular values of trigonometric ratios for the particular angles, or the values of trigonometric ratios for the particular angle 0 degree. Sin 0 is 0, cos 0 is 1, tan 0 is 0, cot 0 is not defined, sec 0 1, and cosec 0 is again not defined.